I'm speaking to Sue Ross, who is founder of an Australian online singing program that boosts children's confidence and helps with mental health and learning difficulties. Welcome to the program, Sue.
Thank you, Maureen. So excited to be here today.
Congratulations on your work, Sue Ross, and also for winning Outstanding Coach Award. How does that feel?
Oh, it just feels amazing. It's been something that it's been a lifelong journey for me to be coaching young people. Prior to starting my business 6 years ago, I was a primary school teacher. And whilst I loved that profession and did it for 20 years in schools in the UK and Australia, it was always there was always something still in the back of my mind that I could reach more young people who didn't have access to music through the school system. And so when I left that previous life and moved into starting my own business, it was just beautiful to see young children initially of my own daughter was 4, and just that sort of instant response to using the voice and wanting to share their voice at such a young age was just so heartwarming. So being recognized for Outstanding Coach has just really sort of put the icing on the cake to know that I'm doing the right thing and being recognized and people understanding my journey as well, which is really beautiful to know.
That's good. So do you come from a singing background yourself as well, apart from being a teacher?
Yes, I think my mum would say it was around the age of 2 I started music lessons, and those music lessons for me as a young person were piano, flute and violin. So I did all my grades as were sort of the thing to do. And then I moved into exploring the voice in terms of the still methodology and more recently the embodiment, which is using your whole body to help your voice become stronger and yourself become more confident. I have always sung. I sang and played piano, and I also love being on stage myself, so using my voice for theatre productions and things on an amateur level, but just really love using the voice. And it's something that's so easy. You know, I don't need to set up my violin or my flute or particularly tune it. So obviously you do some warm-ups and stuff, but it's just something that is readily available to the humans, and we can sing in the car and we can sing wherever we like. So I think that's why it's sort of resonated really well with me.
So how did you start up the Choirs for Kids? Because you're a founder of that too as well, aren't you?
Yes, I am. So back in 2016, I basically left the education system in schools. And my daughter, who, as I said, was 4 at the time, she just was singing nonstop. And I was trying to work out initially what I was going to do. I didn't want to be in the classroom anymore, but I wanted to still do something which was helping children and obviously in the music system. So it was a funny story. I went to a friend's birthday party and we were standing in a park and they said to me, what are you going to do next if you're not in as a teacher? I said, oh, I don't know. And they went through, well, you could come and teach ukulele in our garage, or you could teach, you know, you could teach piano, you can tutor to my children. And it just didn't, I'd done that sort of thing before, but it didn't feel like the thing that I wanted to do. So I said, no, I know what I'm going to do. And I actually happened straight away to walk across to a community centre that was in the same park that we were having the party in. And I walked into the door, and I remember it really vividly. I walked into the door and said, hi, I'm Sue. I want to start a singing group, and I want to use your community centre. And they sort of went, great. So when would you like to start, and what's the name of your group? I hadn't really thought it through, I have to be honest. But it just came out that it was Choirs for Kids, and that's what I was going to do, and it was going to be on a Saturday, and that's how we started, was the small group of around 6 children aged 4 to 6, and then 1 11-year-old who also wanted to sing. And from there, we did that for one school term. And then I opened up another centre, another community centre session in a different part of Perth. And then another one, and another one, and another one. And to cut the story short, over those 4 years of running Choirs4Kids in person, I then ended up doing five different community centre programs around Perth, north to south, and teaching around 80 children or so a week, helping them to use their voice, become confident, and then do some community singing at certain times of the year as well, to perform, you know, with others and by themselves as part of Christmas performance, Christmas fairs and summer fairs and those sorts of things. And then when COVID came, I'd already been looking at how I could change, how I could make the business work on a more day-to-day level. So I enjoyed the teaching and helping these young people, but I didn't necessarily enjoy the travel. So I was traveling from north to south, about 20 hours of travel a week for about 15 hours of leaving time. And so I'd looked at how I could do this in other parts of the world, and obviously online became the thing that I could do. My husband's in IT, which was quite helpful, so we'd already started researching different ways of how we could do this, and was this possible to sing online or to bring groups of people together to sing online. And then COVID came. So March the 20th, I think it was, 2020, the famous date, or around then, I was ready. We'd already started doing some online sessions with children who were unwell or wanted to stay away from in-person sessions in the previous couple of weeks. So I knew it would work, and I just leapt into online and haven't looked back. It's been amazing.
That's very good. And is that how you started home ZoomSing program, you call it?
That's right. So ZoomSing, the name came from singing on Zoom, and the tag has just stuck with us ever since, really. We have tried a few different other programs, but excuse me. we have tried a few different other programs, but Zoom is the one that is ease of use and the best connection. And Zoom have been really supportive in terms of how it all works as well. So, yeah, ZoomSing is now in, I should have the figures to date, 15 countries, and we teach currently 150 young people around the world. So I'm originally from England, so that was the first sort of country we went into after Australia, and then Italy, and then across back this way, so India, Singapore, Japan, lots of parts of Malaysia, Asia, and then all states in Australia. So yeah, ZoomSing Global.
You are providing positive impact on the lives and one's mental health too, aren't you?
I am, yes. It's been something that I hadn't expected. Singing, of course, is so amazing for mental health and for general well-being anyway. But I hadn't experienced the difference that it can make until I moved online. And so now, some of the young people I'm reaching, their programs were no longer accessible due to COVID. And so, you know, their regular support or their regular programs have just disappeared. And I was there, and I would have contacts from emails from people who said, oh, please, can you help my child? They're missing their regular singing program, or I just need something, some sort of break during the day, and I've read that singing is going to really, really help them. And the stories that I've heard since have just been mind-blowing. These young people look of all ages, but more so the young, the preteens and the teens, who have been really struggling throughout this lockdown, not being able to connect with people or not have that release that they have been able to normally have. And I think more than that, it's just brought light, love and hope to the house, the family's house. So they'll hear their young person singing, and you have the change of state in that lesson, so they may go in not feeling so great, but by the time the session is over, they're a little bit more able to regulate themselves. But also, whilst the children are singing, the whole house is filled with music, and we hear so many reports of, oh, my mum's been singing that song, or I see the children going, you know, go away, mum, or whatever, with their hands, you know, or dad, or whoever is at home with them. But the whole family want to get involved, and it's just been beautiful. I've also heard stories of them, you know, just being able to now cope. And I think coping is something that is just been amazing, this whole journey in this current time.
So such a feedback from one of the moms saying that his son has dyslexia and yet his anxiety has been improved a lot after joining the ZoomSing program.
Yes, that's correct as well. We had, that was quite recently, end of last year, where a student who has quite severe dyslexia was not able to really manage his general work, and they'd heard that singing would possibly help this. And so, yes, they sent me an amazing little video and photos of this young boy, now 9 years old, and he was now using his special tools that he has for his dyslexia to read. He was now using that to read the Choirs4Kids songs that we were learning. And then he learnt a particular song. It was actually a Christmas, it was Aussie Jingle Bells, the classic. He learnt his Aussie Jingle Bells song to be part of one of our virtual choirs that we recorded at Christmas. And so he was so proud to be able to be part of that and to sing and to have learnt the words by reading them when he has this disability.
So,
and there's been other cases as well. Oh, sorry. There's been other cases as well where the other children, you know, young children who aren't reading yet, have now started to recognise words, because there's so much involved with Zoom. So even something as simple as when all the sessions are recorded for everyone's protection, but the first thing that comes up when I click on record, first thing that comes up on everybody's screen is, this session is being recorded, do you agree or do you want to leave? So there's already a choice there, and those choices are in words. So for young kids, they've got to learn the words got and it, so they click on got it, or they click on the other one, which I can't remember quite what the option is, but we want them to stay in the session. So we teach them what got it is, and then the colour blue. So if they're not reading yet, they go, okay, it's the blue one. And then we find things around our house as well to help them with, you know, go and find something that's blue, go and find something that's red, go and find a backpack and fill it with things that we can go to the moon on our adventure today. That's for the really young children. So yeah, they're always learning lots of different things apart from just the singing.
That's excellent. What's the website or where someone can contact you to join in the ZoomSing program?
Sure, it's choirs4kids.com. So it's Choirs, the number 4kids.com.
So do you have any last words to conclude with?
Oh, I am just so excited to be able to continue to offer Choirs4Kids ZoomSing to all our young people around the world, and particularly most of my young people are in Australia, where they just get to be themselves, accept their own voice rather than being someone else, and it just helps them feel empowered for the rest of their lives, the rest of their day, the rest of their journey that they have to go through each and every moment.
I guess I'll try and get my grandchildren to join in as well.
Oh, Maureen, that would be lovely. I'd be more than happy to have them do a few sessions with us as part of our program, you know, for you complimentary. So yeah, absolutely.
Thank you very much, Sue Rose, for your time, though.
Thank you, Maureen. It's been lovely to speak with you this morning.
And I've been speaking to Sue Rose, who's an Australian mum and singing coach who brings together children online through song. Thank you very much, Sue. And now we will have this track from Choirs4Kids called Love Shine a Light.
Love shine a light in every corner. name.